what about the other parents? Don't they have a right to know that their child could have potentially been abused by the same predator?
A North Shore mother is speaking out after her son was sexually abused by another student at a Lacombe Elementary School.
Good evening. What has this mother even more upset? Even after admitting to the act, the attacker was never punished.
And WDSU anchor Randy Russo spoke to the mom and explains why she's warning parents to be on alert.
So you can't push it under the rug, or sweep it under the rug, rather, because victims sometimes become the victimizers.
And that's the reason this mother is speaking out, pushing for change after her son was sexually abused at school.
I never in a million years would have thought that that could go on in a school bathroom while class is going on.
The abuse happened at Chattahima Elementary School by another boy. She says that she was shocked to find out this happened not only once, but twice. And it wasn't until a year later that her son finally came forward.
It was hard for him to process something like that in his head. So I think he just assumed people wouldn't believe him because it was so horrible.
The St. Tammany Parish Sheriff's Office says the other student did admit to the assault. The report was turned over to the St. Tammany Parish School Board, and a safety plan was put in place at the school. But this mother says more should have been done.
The child was not expelled or disciplined in any way. So what we were dealing with first day of school was both children are in the same school, the same grade, and on the same bus.
Now, because the abuser is a minor under the age of 10, criminal charges cannot be filed. And at this point, the mother says she's not angry with this boy, but she is asking for a specific sexual abuse action plan and a way to help all kids involved.
I would like to see them take this as serious as they would a child bringing a gun to school or a child talking about bringing a gun to school.
Because there is pending litigation, the St. Tammany Parish School Board says it cannot comment on this case. But Meredith Mendez, Director of Communications with the school board, says we provide district training to all of our counselors on an annual basis. Those counselors are responsible for taking that training back to the teachers in the schools in order to provide them with the tools and resources needed to look for warning signs of any type of abuse. She also says if a parent does have concerns, they should immediately contact the school principal or even the school board. Now, this abuse is more common than you realize. Jesse Hartley with Hope House says many children are even fearful to tell, but this kind of abuse does happen.
It absolutely can happen. I mean, we have seen actual, you know, intercourse between children. And like I said, that's sexual acting out by a child is often a sign that they have been abused or are being abused.
Hartley says right now they are working with about 250 kids who've been sexually abused, which is an increase from just last year.
Internally, there's a lot of shame. There's a lot of guilt. They've oftentimes they've been threatened by the abuser. Sometimes with the younger children, they don't even know that what is happening is wrong.
This mother says that parents may have reason to be concerned if their kids went to Chattahima and is urging them to have a conversation with their child.
If there is a kid that this happened to, that kid needs to talk about it. That kid needs some kind of justice or closure. They need to know that it wasn't their fault, and they need to get the help that they need.
On your side, I'm Randy Russo, WDSU News.
And we should also add to Randy's report that the mother of the young boy who was in the second grade at the time of the assault is now seeking damages from the St. Tammany Parish School Board in the amount of $50,000.